by covering the leaf mites, covering those open holes you see there, by trying to use good techniques, by trying to close the mite in an appropriate manner. The governments have been able to have a department that makes sure that this mite has come to life to the returning of those environments to the original state under the solid Ministry of Mines and State Development. If you go to the next page again, the government headquarters, you see they've been trying to do a lot, trying to make the mining environment much more better. They provide technical assistance. The World Bank have been doing that, but they just ended that program on World Bank this past month. They've been able to improve the livelihood through sustainability, giving the miners rights, they've been able to make reforms to fit more policies, more reforms to make the environment better. This is what the government has been trying to do. They've also been able to do, like I said, mine environmental compliance department under the Ministry of Mines and Steel. They are more like the police that watch the miners. Make sure they don't leave those mines in those states. You make sure they come back to the original state and make the environment more green, more friendly, more healthy, you know, less pollution. The miners have not much, but they have tried to they've been able to form corporations to take the grants the government have given them to utilize it. Acquiring new equipment, modern equipment. Few have been trying to enforce the compliance. Few, not much effort so far. The conclusion, I think the next page, I think the way we do the environment makes the environment better. And if this ways change to renewable energy, it's a green investment. I think it will also increase growth and create employment. I think much more money, revenue, all about. And that's what I have for you today.
Starting implementation, maybe to also talk about implement, maybe workshop concerning this. For example, here is sharing best practice challenges recently. I think according to Pavilion for implementation for Turkey, maybe can make initiative to make a workshop, inviting or seminar, inviting participants from the 8 member countries concerning this program, concerning about green SME.
Our young presentation to last page, we submitted some proposal. It will be better to initiate our SMEs. We must use the eight secretaries' web page for share our best practice in virtually monthly. We can get more information in that webpage, and this information also be distributed to our SMEs, countries' SMEs, by institutions' webpage also. The activation began with this issue, and then our second proposal is B2B meeting.
Biz bir B2B'leri ilk yapma konusunda bir öncü olabilir mi?
Turkey can initiate the B2B business trip for this issue with the with any countries for an example. Then we can continue the other countries. I think that second, the next year we can arrange matchmaking on environment friendly and between the companies.
You mean you make B2B meeting, invite private sector from
for SMEs. Maybe we can invite your countries to Turkey, and in Turkey it will be
Inviting private sector sometimes is not easy one, especially if they should fund by themselves. For example, we only invite them without giving them ticket. It's not easy one. Maybe the practical one is sending information. Sending information, for example, you expert come to Indonesia and to share experience about the business sector, especially for small and medium enterprises. And maybe also you come also to other countries, to other T8 member countries. But if inviting B2B, I'm afraid it's difficult for them to come. It's not easy to come because, of course, they need the care, accommodation, and usually for small and medium enterprises, it's not easy to afford. Yeah, but I also would like to comment about the web page. And it's good one, I think, the web page. Maybe in what bit with the content of web page, maybe coming from other countries, especially the 8 member countries, implementation about green production. But the information is sent to secretariat and so that will upload in internet or upload in website. So we know the development of the implementation of green production in each country of the 8 member countries. That is the one. Thank you.
This exchanging information discussed. I would like to draw your attention to this manual printed by Nigeria, which talks about the first stage of Sami's governmental bodies being the final report. And that report, Article 1,
So.
The first thing it was predicted that further collaborations among the member countries, we will certainly need a mean by which we can communicate through each member country. So it was suggested that member countries establish a communication network through which the member countries can communicate and share information, exchange information, such as so that communication. And then underneath this communication network, after it was being being approved, then we actually had to come up with a virtual network, which is what France talked about, a base on which we can have the information through the secretariat. Based on this, we, after a second SMEs meeting in Turkey, we proposed our communication network proposal that was a simple duty. To study this directive of establishing such communication network, and that
long-term this project at the end of
objectives, we have very good outcomes to share with the countries. So, but for the, as a first step, we can put the information about this issue to the Create Secretariat web page or if the communication network is upgraded and currently work, we can also use that platform.
National Environmental Policy of the Federal Government of 1999 is a key policy document that stipulates the principles for sustainable development. Policies and programs under broad categories of the governmental pillar are related to four essentials: biodiversity, pollution control, land degradation, water management, climate change, marine and coastal environment, energy, clean energy and environmental crime. Government has taken the issue of environmental pollution and degradation seriously. Various national efforts have been made, put in place at all levels of governments to promote environmental sustainability in the context of national sustainable development. Government has created some institutional arrangements for environmental governance. The Federal Ministry of Environment is pursuing its mandate of, one, securing quality environmental conditions for good health, well-being of fauna and flora, promoting sustainable use of natural resources, restoring and maintaining the ecosystem, ecological process, and preserving biodiversity. Four, raising public awareness and promoting understanding of leakage of the environment. Then, now, specific agencies have been created to provide more focused attention to some specific environmental problems. They include the National Oil Spill Detection and the Response Agency, NASRA, and National Environmental Standards and Regulations Enforcement Agency, NESRA, which were created respectively in 2006 and 2007. NASRA has the mandate to make the National Oil Spill Contingency Plan. NASRA has responsibility to enforce all environmental laws, guidelines, policies, standards, and regulations in Nigeria, as well as enforce compliance with the provisions of all international agreements, protocols, conventions, and treaties on environment, to which Nigeria is a signatory. From 2007 to 2012, Nigeria has developed 24 environmental regulations, which have been accepted, and they are in various stages of operationalism. These regulations have key provisions for environmental control, limit, and remedies. Other institutions include forest management, research, institutions of Nigeria, FRI, national parks, environmental health offices, regulations called Council of Nigeria, FRI is mandated to conduct search into all aspects of forestry, wildlife management, agroforestry, Nigeria recognizes that it faces many challenges in moving its economy to more environmentally friendly, green and sustainable power. In this regard, the country has obtained that necessary conditions must be established in the global and regional level to make it possible for developing countries move forward in green economy within the framework of UN's principles and agenda. The tenets of the economy should be consistent with the sustainable development concepts, principles and framework, with continued focus on poverty reduction, which remain a major global development challenge.
Infrastructure is a very, very common SMEs. The paper agrees with the view of virtually everybody. Virtually everybody knows the importance of SMEs in our countries. That's what agrees with you. And D8 is looking for a way of technical and engineering services cooperation among its members. So the paper just agreed that a general look at SMEs brings out four things that SMEs have, and it listed them as engineering equipment, engineering materials, engineering skills, and then managerial skills. Broadly speaking, these are the four areas that SMEs are in their need of skills. And the paper feels that if there's going to be any technical cooperation, it should be around this, should involve around this area. Now, when talking about engineering and technology and infrastructure, the paper would like to regard infrastructure as a combination, it's not as one thing, but a combination of two, three things. A combination of man, that is a capital human infrastructure, the combination of machine, which is other infrastructure and facilities, and then the funding, that's the money that goes into it. All these three things should be taken as infrastructure because you need all the combination of all of them to get these things moving. On the other hand, technology is more defined. When you look at the next page, that is national, where it talks about technology. You find out that technology is a lot of things. Technology includes management. Technology includes using the things. Technology includes developing the people. If you don't do all those things, you are not talking technology altogether. And for SMEs, the paper identifies two major areas in technology, where you have information and communication technology, which is necessary for every SME. Whether you are into production, whatever you are into, if you don't adopt that, then our SMEs will go back. The other aspect identified by the paper is advanced manufacturing technologies, where you do with the old way of doing things, the conventional way of doing things. You adopt things like CNC, modern technologies and emerging technologies which you can teach SMEs to adopt them and then use them, which you can, our SMEs can adopt and use. In this country, the paper went to say that in this country, Sweden and Laseni, the National Agency for Engineering Infrastructure, have signed an MOA collaboration between them, where these technologies, between them, they take these technologies and take them to SMEs. Because we recognize that unlike other countries, we don't have equity or venture capitalists. We found that SMEs needed capital. Even where you finance them, that is not the end. Because how to deploy your finances, that's the managerial aspect. Now, even if you adopt green technology and give them, we need somebody to teach them how to develop technologies. And we are the opinion that that may be the general practice everywhere. We need mentoring. There has to be a way of mentoring our SMEs using finances and so on. And that is what Sweden and Naseni are doing with some of the technologies that are developed. You can see some of those developed, the picture of some of those developed technologies. Area of renewable energy, we have areas of small hydropower production, copper production. We also have area of materials, carbon mining, poultry forests, most poultry forests, which are used to get several materials and so on. We have areas where we are able to develop spare parts for motorcycles and so on, which SMEs, the machines are there, the facilities are there. It's just for SMEs to come, use the facilities, produce them, and go and sell them at the public state. And you are charged just just some little tokens to keep the place running. And we are recommending that such are the things that DA companies can take from each other and help the small scale SMEs. Now, on our recommendations, we are recommending that in the, for instance, page 8, we are recommending that DA countries should intensify efforts towards, first of all, you adopt technology where you don't have it. And where you adopt it, you domesticate it. Make it simpler for people that where you have to understand the technology. Domesticate the technology. But better still, if you can use your own indigenous technology and evolve it, because that's what the people can use, then that will be better. Because if I'm talking to Iran, and he's interpreting directly what he has done to me in his own way, it is better for me to understand. The local man will understand it that way than the other recommendation is the assimilation and diffusion of these technologies. You may have these technologies all over the place. You have to bring them together. And bringing them together, you don't leave them there. You have to find a way of making these SMEs have facilities, have access to these technologies to make use of them. Then the next one is the DA countries have to develop or deliberately and objectively mentor these SMEs. You have to have a policy to deliberately and objectively mentor them, teach them, bring them up to a certain stage so that they will be able to stand on their own. And of course, in doing that, there must be sacrifice for someone, either government or venture capitalists or anyone. Somebody has to sacrifice. Somebody has to put in funds. Somebody has to put in time and so on. Financing, of course, we have know that we need to finance all these kinds of efforts. In conclusion, we are saying that these countries will team up and share from their policies. Some of us don't have adequate policies that bring up this. If the DA country can sit down and say, let's look at this meeting, let's look at the policies of each country. What is it that country A is doing that is going well that country B is not doing? Or country C is doing that country D is not doing? We can learn from the policies and then we can come back and then assist each other. That. The next point is, within the DA countries, we can exchange these indigenously developed technologies or these adopted technologies. One country may be better in understanding what the technology that